Most of the guidelines suggest that high glycemic index forms of carbohydrate foods are better at glycogen resynthesis than low GI foods. And that's because the characteristic of these foods is that they produce a high glucose response and a high insulin response, and both those characteristics would be favourable for muscle glycogen resynthesis. But the study that we did 20 years ago found those effects, but probably not for the reasons of the glucose and insulin responses. Possibly the main reason that the high GI foods seem to be better is that they are actually well absorbed and digested, whereas some of the low GI foods tend to be malabsorbed. So what you eat in your mouth doesn't always get digested and appear to your muscle. In real life, I suggest to people that they choose foods that have a range of nutritional characteristics that are good for them, as well as things that they like eating. And I don't really distinguish too much between the high GI and the low GI foods in the general diet, but maybe immediately post-exercise, the high GI foods might be more favourable. I think when you think about the whole makeup of the carbohydrate in your diet, you want to think of a whole range of characteristics, not just what's happening to muscle glycogen most of the time, but in situations where refueling is really important, then maybe that's where the GI might count.